Now here are some local corporate headlines. The Manila Mining Corporation is issued an exploration permit covering a near 508-hectare property in Surigao del Sur. It's the same site of an authority to verify minerals that enabled MMC to drill five holes from March 2022 to March 2023. As for Ital Pinas, it approves the entry of a strategic investor by way of private placement. Benjamin Tanco subscribing to 94.4 million common shares or a 13% stake for nearly 188 million pesos. The partnership will allow Ital Pinas to expand to new locations. Co has a broad portfolio from petrochemicals to steel manufacturing, as well as land holdings in Palawan, Cavite, and Boracay, among others. And finally, former Metro Pacific Tollways President and CEO Rogelio Singson could be moving to the MVP Group's water business. But he clarifies it's too early to tell which unit or project he will be assigned to, as well as the role he has served in these units.
I was told the MVP wants me to go to the MP Group, no? Head office. To do, I think my understanding is water sector ulit. Water sector in MPIC, kasi marami investments ang MPIC sa tubig. It's early days, so in fact, I really don't know yet at this time. Wala pa naman kaming, basta nabanggit lang na ganito after November 21.
A business group seeks consistency and regularity from the Philippine government amid the rift between the country's top officials. Management Association of the Philippines President Rene Almendra says the Philippines needs to show local and international investors it is business as usual. Almendra also cites the would-be trade policies of U.S. President-elect Donald Trump as another uncertainty the business community is facing.
Our competitive as a country is also determined by the image and our reputation as a country. So most important to business is consistency and regularity of policy. I am hoping that that will continue to be and will be emphasized as we go through these politically challenging times.
Let's check on European markets. They are mostly higher in afternoon trade. This is as investors cheered U.S. President Donald Trump's nominee for Treasury Secretary, hedge fund manager Scott Bessent, who is expected to keep a leash on U.S. debt. Bessent told the Wall Street Journal in an interview published on Sunday that both tax and spending cuts were priorities. Over in the U.S., futures for the major indices are also pointing to a positive open ahead of a shortened trading week due to the Thanksgiving holiday. And focus this week, the Personal Consumption Expenditure or PCE Price Index, which is the Federal Reserve's preferred gauge of inflation. Now here are some stocks to watch out for. Monitoring shares of Atos, which has received a non-binding offer from the French government for its advanced computing activities. Its share skyrocketed 163% in midday trading. Also in focus, shares of UniCredit and Banco BPM. That's after UniCredit launched a surprise bid to buy its rival for $10.5 billion. UniCredit shares tanked 4%, while Banco BPM shares rose 2%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Kingfisher after the home improvement company missed third quarter earnings forecasts. The stock tumbled 13% on that news.